more time to Real Shame, a show where us two fellas talk about our list of movie blind spots, movies that we maybe haven't seen or actually have not seen over the years and are now watching those movies and discussing them amongst ourselves and to you if you care for that sort of thing. My name is Andy.
And I'm Adam.
And this is our special Mother's Day episode. I think last year the first year that we did a Mother's Day?
Yeah, I think we did.
We didn't do one the first year, I guess, I think this is our third year, right, of doing this. So last year we did Mommy Dearest.
That's right.
And this year we decided to do a slightly different movie about a mother and daughter, or in this case maybe two daughters. Adam's going to tell you all about the movie that we're going to talk about for this special Mother's Day episode.
All right, determined to make her beautiful, gifted daughter June a vaudeville headliner, willful and resourceful, domineering even, stage mother Rose Havoc will stop at nothing to achieve this goal in Gypsy.
You're behind, Louise. Catch up, dear. Catch up.
Hold it. Please get off the stage, please.
Didn't I see your sensitive face at the Odd Fellows Hall? My first husband was an odd fellow.
I'm not an odd fellow.
I mean Knight of Pythias. My second husband
was an Knight of Pythias.
Aren't you anything?
I'm an elk.
Oh, I should have known it by your good manners. My father's an elk, too. 1853 Seattle, Washington. I got his tooth here someplace because I'm an honorable elk.
Hi, Bill.
Oh, would you mind holding Charlesy? That's short for Charmaine. Mama just loves Charmaine, doesn't she, Charlesy? Stop sucking your thumb, Louise. Professor, I just marvel how you can make a performer into an artist. So if you could help my little girls by giving them a nice, loud da-da-da-da-da. Oh, Mr. Sipser.
Yes.
When my girls do their specialty, would you please add lickets?
Sure.
Show them, girls.
You're the boss. What am I supposed to do?
Get her out of here.
Oh, Mr. Electrical, would you please spot baby June? She's the one with all the movement, and every little movement has a meaning all its own. So hit her with something pink. Or would you prefer amber? I never can make up my mind what color to use.
All right, Gypsy came out, and you have 1962. It is 1962. It is written by Leonard Spielgass and directed by Marvin Leroy. This is what I was looking for. Spielgass has written 11 Academy Award-winning films, apparently, according to his IMDb.
That's a big number.
That's a big number. Leroy, I picked a couple from his list. He did the Wizard of Oz movie and Mr. Roberts. So Gypsy, a Musical Fable, is a musical that came out in 1959 with music by Julie Stein and lyrics by, who I think even non-theater people would know, Stephen Sondheim, and a book by Arthur Lawrence. Gypsy's loosely based on the 1957 memoirs of a striptease artist named Gypsy Rose Lee, and it focuses on her mother, Rose, whose name has become synonymous with the ultimate show business kind of mother. So we've all seen that kind of, what's it called?
Helicopter mom.
Helicopter mom. Yeah. Yeah, we've seen that in numerous films.
JonBenet Ramsey's parents or whatever.
So this is kind of like the starting of all that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
So Gypsy is a movie that it's a musical that we both haven't seen. So and it was a movie that was recommended to us by Kirby, and because Kirby really likes this musical and this movie. So we were like, it fits the criteria about it being about a mom. And we're watching it here for you on Mother's Day. So I didn't know anything about Gypsy going into it. And did you know anything about it?
Yeah, not really. I mean, I've seen the poster before of like with Rosalind Russell and with Natalie Wood kind of like hiding, you know, kind of stripping, basically hiding herself. And that's about it. I'm not even sure I knew that it was a musical. I mean, don't get me wrong. I knew that there was a musical called Gypsy. But for some reason, I thought that the movie didn't have songs in it. I thought that it was just a straight, like, drama kind of thing. So when they started singing, I was like, oh, it is indeed a musical. I mean, it's based on the musical, and they took the songs from the musical.
Yeah.
So, I mean, yeah, I knew Rosalind Russell and Natalie Wood were in it, but I didn't really know a whole lot about it. And this is also one of those movies that I was worried that maybe I had seen it before. I mean, again, not that that would be that big a deal. I mean, because I knew you hadn't seen it. But when I started watching it, nope, never seen it.
Yeah.
I was like, this does not look familiar to me.
It's the opposite of what I've experienced before.
Yeah. But anyway, yeah. So, did you already go through the cast list?
I did not. But yeah, feel free to take the cast list on.
So Rosalind Russell plays Rose. so it's like Hovick sometimes and sometimes Havoc. Because okay. I know it's like June Havoc, but I know their name was Hovick, but they also went by Havoc. So Rose Hovick, Havoc, whatever you want to call her. Carl Malden, long before he was the American Express spokesperson, don't leave home without it. Or, and also he was the president of the Motion Picture Arts and Arts and Sciences Academy, whatever, back in like 1989 for a few years. But long before he did either one of those things, he was an actor. He plays Herbie Summers in this movie. Suzanne Capito is how she's billed. She would later change her name to Morgan Brittany, but she plays Baby June. She's known to audiences of TV show or TV's Dallas, that show from the 80s. Okay. Aunt Jillian, who plays June Havoc, Hovick / Dainty June. Aunt Jillian was also in a TV show in the 80s called It's a Living. Diane Pace plays Baby Louise. And Natalie Wood, we all know Natalie Wood. We've seen her in Rebel Without a Cause. And is that it? Have we seen her in anything else so far on the show? I don't know. Maybe just Rebel Without a Cause. But anyway, she plays Louise Hovick / Gypsy Rose Lee. And of course, a year before this movie, she had done West Side Story, also by Stephen Sondheim, or lyrics by Stephen Sondheim. And this movie also has very small roles or very small appearances from Jack Benny, playing himself, the comedian Jack Benny, and Harvey Korman, for those of you that love the Carol Burnett show. He was on that show a lot, and he's in a lot of other stuff, but he's at the very, very end of the movie. But that is the cast list. So, yeah, I mean, I'd never seen this movie before. You've never seen this before. I've already talked about kind of what I knew about it.
Yeah,
Should I jump into what I think about it?
Go for it.
So, I mean, I remember, obviously, I was here with you when Kirby recommended it, but I didn't realize she had recommended it because she liked the movie. I thought that it was just a movie that she knew was about a stage mom. But so I didn't really know, you know, kind of what to expect as I watched this. And as it got going, I don't know, I think it was maybe a little bit rough to start. But once I kind of settled in, I actually did enjoy this movie. I don't know that the songs blew me away. I mean, some of them, like Everything's Coming Up Roses or whatever, like that. I've heard, you know, some of this music, but a lot of it I was unfamiliar with, and it didn't make, honestly, a huge impression on me. So the musical aspect of it was okay. You know, this is not like Oklahoma or something where I feel like I know like a lot of the songs. But I would say overall, I did enjoy the movie. I mean, it's a bit on the long side.
Yes,
but it is. Some of these older musicals are. I mean, West Side Story is super long as well, right? The original, the new one's not as long as the original one. I think mercifully, it's a little bit shorter. But I mean, not that it's bad. It's good. But this movie's a little bit long. And what I thought was funny is for a movie that features a stripper, basically, or it's based on the memoirs of a stripper, none of the stripping happens until there's like 20 minutes left in the movie. Like 2 hours of the movie basically has elapsed before she finally is like going to become this Gypsy Rose Lee character. Because up to this point, she's just Louise or whatever, or Rose Lee or whatever they call her. But I found that kind of interesting. I also don't think that the movie focuses that much on Natalie Wood. I feel like the main focus of the movie is Rosalind Russell. Yeah. And Rosalind Russell's efforts to make, you know, Baby June, Dainty June a star. Natalie Wood is very much in the background. I mean, she definitely has screen time. She does the one kind of dance and song with the guy.
Yeah.
I forget his name already. But
he's named after a city.
They were all named after cities. Was it like Tulsa and Yonkers and all this stuff. I thought that was kind of funny. But she has a number with him. And you know, I mean, she's definitely present in the movie. But I feel like the focus of the movie is the Mama Rose character by far. So I think the title's maybe a little bit misleading because it's definitely not all about Gypsy. But I thought overall, I mean, I liked it. I think Rosalind Russell is really good. She, you know, in her role, she's really great. I love Carl Malden. Like, I think Carl Malden is just a great actor. I think he plays a great character. He's like the voice of reason. You know, he wants to do the practical thing. He loves the Rosalind Russell character. He cares about the family. Yeah. He wants to do what's right for them. And he tries as much as he can to, you know, not have Rosalind Russell, Rose Hovick's character, you know, get in her own way. But she does constantly. And you know, he doesn't like the fact that there towards the end that Natalie Wood is going to become a stripper, obviously with good reason. So all these things. But I love his character. But I thought overall it was good. The family dynamic stuff didn't always work for me. And again, the music's okay. But I think overall, just based on the performances, it held my interest, even though it was 2 hours and 20 minutes, it held my interest. So I would say I liked it overall, but this is definitely, you know, not one of the best musicals I've ever seen. I mean, by a wide margin. What about you?
I agree with everything you said, although I feel a little more lukewarm towards the the movie and the musical. For me, like, musicals are made or maked or braked or by the music.
Yeah.
And like you said, none of the songs are really that memorable or that great to me. So it's just kind of like, I'm just watching this really long story about a stage mom and like we're breaking out a song and I don't really care about the song. So for me, I was just, you know, checking my proverbial watch, hoping it would end.
Oh, okay.
And it did seem very, very long. So Kirby was enjoying every bit of it.
I was going to ask, did you watch it with her?
Yeah, singing along and moving along. And I'm just kind of like, okay, is it over yet? So I agree with what you said about Carl Malden. You know, he was hashtag family before Vin Diesel was even around and wanted to keep everything together. So I think it's interesting, but I think it could. I don't know why it's not focused on Gypsy, right? On Gypsy Rose Lee.
Yeah,
like it feels like that's like a missed opportunity, you know?
Yeah.
And I know this thing's got some accolades, both the movie and the musical, so maybe I'm just missing it. But for me, it's just like, I think, you know, she's less interesting than both Baby June and you know, Baby Louise. Like, I think are more interesting characters than she is. And I don't know why the show keeps on focused on her so much. You know, so for me, that just felt like a missed opportunity. I never really connected with the movie or the musical or really cared about what was going on.
Yeah, I feel like you get a lot. You definitely get the characterization of the Mama Rose character and the domineering stage mother. You see that front and center the whole movie. But I think that overshadows any kind of development that they do with the Natalie Wood character. And then at the end, it's just like, Mama, I've always wanted you to notice me. You get little snatches of that throughout the movie, but I don't feel like you get enough of it to ever really call the movie Gypsy.
Yeah.
I mean, the movie should be called Rose, if anything.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, because it's more about
Gypsy's mom.
Yeah, Gypsy's mom, something. Because I felt like Natalie Wood very much got shuffled to the background for most of the movie, even though she, you know, she's present, and she does have, you know, a number or two here and there. But it's more about the Rose character than it is about Gypsy. I mean, and I get, yes, it's based on Gypsy's memoirs, and so they called the musical Gypsy and whatnot, and they call the movie Gypsy. I understand it, but it doesn't make a lot of sense to me as far as, you know, what their focus is on. But, yeah, I mean, I think this movie is fairly well-received, but I've never heard anybody talk about the music or really place this alongside South Pacific or Oklahoma or some of these other musicals that are just like knock your socks off with their music
West
and their
Side
lyrics.
Story.
West Side Story. Yeah. I don't feel like it's in that, you know, upper kind of echelon of movies. I feel like it's a fairly well-received musical, but it's somewhere in the middle. At least that's what I get out of it. And that's where I would place it. I mean, it's not a musical. Maybe it takes repeat viewings for these songs to really grow on you, but I ain't going to be watching this anytime soon.
Did you notice that Rosalind Russell was dubbed?
To me, honestly, I did not notice that she was dubbed. I mean, I felt like that was her real voice because to me it matched. It didn't seem unnatural. But yeah, afterwards I read that it wasn't her most of the time. I know that in some cases they kind of blended her voice with the lady who dubbed her. But to me, it worked. I mean, it didn't seem off. It didn't seem jarring to me when she would open her mouth. It sounded like that sound would actually come from Rosalind Russell's mouth, basically. And I did read also that even though Natalie Wood did not do her own singing in West Side Story, she did do her own singing for this movie. And she's not bad.
I think she's decent.
She's not Marnie Nixon or whoever sang for her in West Side Story. She's not that good.
Yeah.
But she's okay. She's not too bad.
So the musical, ended up getting nominated for Best Musical in the 1960 Tony Awards. It did not win. Hmm. I didn't write down who won. But in the 1989 Tony Awards, it won for Best Revival.
Interesting.
And the movies got a couple of accolades. It got... are these nominations?
Yeah, I didn't win.
It got nominated for Best Cinematography Color. Got nominated for Best Costume Design Color. Best Music... Best scoring of music and best scoring music adaptation. Or, you probably have this better than I do.
I had the winner, yeah. And I agree with the winner.
so this kind of was like highly acclaimed a little bit.
Yeah,
it didn't win any awards, but you know, it was looked like it was well received. So, who won some of those categories?
Yeah, so I sent you a link to a YouTube video that talks about Technorama.
I noticed
that this movie was made in Technorama, and I was kind of interested to see, like, what exactly is that? Technorama was an alternative to CinemaScope, because back in the mid-1950s, when movies were trying to compete with television, they thought, what can we offer that television doesn't have? And that is a wider picture. So instead of being a square, you know, they started making widescreen films. And I know CinemaScope was a process that they used early on to make movies with an anamorphic lens, where so basically they would take the picture and squeeze it into a box, and then when they projected it, it would unsqueeze it, but it, you know, it could make a widescreen film. And again, Technorama was kind of an alternative to CinemaScope, but apparently Technorama did not last. It was used in the 1950s all the way up until basically the mid-1960s, and then they just kind of dropped it. But according to that video that we watched, they did still continue to use it. Maybe they still continue to use it now for some special effects kind of shots. Like they showed Star Wars. Like they were using it. They were using the cameras to make some like optical effects or effect shots, special effect shots. So they don't shoot movies with it so much anymore, but they do maybe still use it to make visual effects. But I think it's kind of interesting. I think the look of the film is kind of interesting because it does have very wide kind of vistas, even though most of the time they're just like on a stage. Or they're backstage, or they're, you know, out in their little tents or whatever, that kind of thing. But everybody looks very kind of elongated and tall, so it has an interesting look. But the winners, I said all that to lead up to the winners of the Oscars that this movie was nominated for, are all kind of widescreen movies. So it was nominated, as you said, for color cinematography. It lost to Lawrence of Arabia, which was shot using Super Panavision 70, so 70 millimeter.
That's crazy.
Widescreen. It was nominated for color costume design. It lost to The Wonderful World of the Brothers Grimm, which was a Cinerama film. And Cinerama was the thing, very few movies were made with the Cinerama process, but Cinerama was basically three screens put together, but they were curved. So it was a huge curved screen, and they were projected side by side. So very kind of odd looking, but like How the West Was Won is another Cinerama movie, and The Wonderful World of the Brothers Grimm won. But the movie that beat out Gypsy for score is The Music Man, and that was another Technorama film. Music Man's awesome. 100%. I love the music for that. Now that is a musical that I think pretty much every song from that is memorable as hell. So I can totally get behind that beating out Gypsy for score, because that's got an amazing, amazing score. And if you've not seen that, we definitely need to watch that. I guarantee you will like the music in that. It's very catchy. And you've probably heard, you'll probably watch it and go, oh, I know the song, because it's really good. So this movie was released on Blu-ray by Warner Archive back in 2012, so 10 years ago. So you can see it that way. And Bette Midler starred in a 1993 CBS version. Oh. Yeah, and apparently the girl that played Baby June, I don't know who played the older June in that movie, I can't remember, but the girl that played Baby June was Elizabeth Moss.
Oh, interesting.
And the girl that played Baby Louise was Lacey Chabert. Yeah. Again, I don't know who played the older versions of those characters. But, that, yeah, so I've never seen that version. I didn't know it existed either. And this movie is 64% fresh on Rotten Tomatoes, 74% audience. Didn't find a Roger Ebert or Gene Siskel, but Leonard Maltin gives it 3 out of 4 stars.
All right. Well, that was our Mother's Day episode. Happy Mother's Day to
Happy
you
Mother's Day!
Mothers out there. Stay tuned next week for our normal episodes. But that was everything Gypsy and More. Let us know what you think in the comments down below. And we'll see you on Monday, so just 24 hours from now. We'll see you soon, guys.